Hi, my name is Ward Becker. Today, we'll get you up and running with Loki on the Google Kubernetes Engine. Loki is a brand new open source aggregation tool for unstructured logs. Because of its unique indexing approach, it's much easier to scale and operate than popular tools like Elasticsearch or Splunk. It's also very cost-effective for storing and querying very large amounts of log data. In this tutorial, we're using the Google Bigtable NoSQL database for the label indexes and Google Cloud Storage for the actual logs. The logs are stored in native Loki format called Chunk. Before we start, I assume you have a Google Cloud Platform account and have the Cloud SDK installed on your local workstation. Great, let's create a fresh Kubernetes cluster. In the console, go to the Kubernetes Engine and select Create Cluster. The standard cluster settings are okay for today. The only change we need to make is in the node pool settings. The nodes need to be able to access the relevant Google Cloud API. This is needed to give low-key access to Bigtable and Google Cloud Storage for persistence. The creation of the cluster takes about 5 minutes. So while that is being created, let's create our Bigtable database. In the console, we go to the Bigtable page and create a new instance. A development instance is fine for this tutorial. Make sure it's in the same region for good performance. Last resource we need to create is a cloud storage bucket to store our Loki chunks. Again, pick same region for good performance. We're gonna leave the rest of the configuration option on its default setting. Switching back to the Kubernetes Engine tab. The creation of our cluster just finished and is now ready for you. As we're gonna control the cluster from our local command line interface, we need to configure kubectl with the correct credentials. For an easy install of Loki, we'll use Helm, which is a popular Kubernetes package manager. And as Kubernetes on the Google Cloud Platform uses role-based access control, we need to create a service account and role binding. It's for the Tiller service that comes with Helm and needs to be running on the cluster. To create these new resources, we pass the following configuration to kubectl. Now we are ready to install Tiller on the cluster. Great. Next, let's install Loki. For this, we need to provide our Google Cloud configuration when we install the Loki Helm chart. Great, looks good. Now let's install Grafana so we can explore our logs. Open Grafana on localhost port 3000. Add the Loki data source, that's on port 3100. And go to explore. I'm gonna select the last 5 minutes and we're gonna select a stream. For example, in this case, the standard error stream. That's it for today. We successfully installed Loki on Google Cloud Kubernetes Cluster with Bigtable and Google Cloud Storage for persistence. Don't forget to shut down your resources if you're done with your test. And thanks for watching and see you next time.